This is Robb Elementary, where a gunman killed 19 students, children, and two staff members, both teachers, back on May 24th, 2022. It's been nearly a year, and let me show you what's here now in front of the campus. There are 21 wooden white crosses, one for every victim, a sunflower at the base. Some have stones on them, painted. Some have pictures. And look on the top here. These are the two teachers. And on the very top here, there's a penny with a cross cut out in the middle here. In the back, you see the school has been boarded up. There are some windows that have plywood on them, some of them still shot out and not repaired. Students will not come back to this school. It has been closed since the shooting, and it's likely that students will never learn at this campus again. We've been here now for parts of 2 days, and what we've noticed, what we've been struck by, is that people keep coming by here on a regular basis to pay their respects, to look at this scene, to ponder what this mass shooting in America means and the lives that are lost. We spoke with a couple. They were traveling and they came by here because they read in their local newspaper not just about the crosses, but about murals that have been drawn in the city center. We talked to a man who says his cousin was a victim here, died, and he comes by this site about 3 to 4 times a week, usually with his grandson, who he's watching. And we also talked to a woman, a substitute teacher from San Antonio, about an hour and a half from here. She came here because she wanted to pay tribute, to honor the memories of her fellow teachers and the students that died here. We also went into the town square in the middle of the town here, and there is also a big memorial there. There are some crosses, but there are also handwritten notes. There are photographs. There are little mementos and the painted stones. Pieces that start to tell you a little bit about these 21 lives. And here at Robb Elementary, it has struck us how heavy the air is here and how people come with reverence and keep their voices down even when they're here. It is because of the shooting in Uvalde that we started our Securing Our Schools investigation. After that shooting, we thought, what are schools doing right now to keep students and teachers safe? There was no current snapshot of that, and that's why we sent a questionnaire to every public school district in all 50 states. The number one finding, many districts told us they know they're not doing enough to keep their schools safe, but they can't afford to do more. Can't afford to do more in America today. In Uvalde, Texas, I'm Chief National Investigative Correspondent Mark Albert.